From the Mint, along Leadenhall Street, down Cornhill past the Exchange to the old lady of Threadneedle Street herself. Here it turns into the side entrance and drives straight into the bullion yard. Now there's the escort, armed. There's the watchman at the Mint, the porters at the bank, all armed. There's not a chance, Mr. O'Shea. If it's the bank itself you're thinking of, we'd never get near it. Oh, sure, it's fine for the boys in Dublin to say, do this and do that. Why does it have to be a bank?
That's where the money is, Mr. Walsh.
But why the Bank of England?
Because there's more of it there than anywhere else.
Then it'll have to be the bullion van.
What's the capacity of the van, Dr. Hagen?
There are four bars to a box, each 400 ounces troy weight.
Yes, the value, Dr. Hagen?
160,000 pounds.
That's a lot of anybody's money.
Yes, but not enough of England's.
What does the movement expect? A million, maybe?
160,000 pounds is a matter for the police. A million is a political offensive. It also lasts longer.
So there are other places to find money.
Robbing grocers' tills and blowing up public lavatories will not make a nation out of Ireland, Mr. Walsh.
It disposes of a few Englishmen.
Huh. They breed like rabbits. Where are the vaults?
I'm sure there are arrows all over the place pointing the way. I'm telling you, it's a dream, Mr. O'Shea. The Bank of England hasn't been robbed in all its history. 207 years.
Yeah. Finality, Mr. Walsh, is not the language of politics.
Mrs. Muldoon, please.
Come in, sir.
He was engaged in New York on the advice of our friends there. They have contributed towards his expenses.
Yeah, what does he care about Ireland?
His mother was Irish.
So is mine. What else qualifies him for this job?
He's a professional, Mr. Walsh.
We need more than a set of burglar's tools.
He has more. He was a mining engineer, but he found it easier to extract gold from banks than from frozen streams.
You have a letter?